everyone, this is Stephanie Rittermount with Courageous Living. My passion is to help you maximize your gifts and talents within you to go further and farther than you ever thought possible. And one of the ways I do that is through these motivational videos. And today I want to talk about doing a mid-year check-in on your goals. Let's take some time to see where you're at. How are you doing on your goals? In this video, I want to share some things with you about how you can pause, step back, reflect and evaluate, adjust and reset, and then achieve those goals. So maybe you can relate to this. It's the beginning of the year, you're all excited, it's a fresh new year. You have all your goals planned and written down, your vision board's all put together, you have that word for the year that you're gonna line up all your goals to, and everything's going great and you're off to a great start. But then maybe 6 or 7 months in, you might be plateauing, maybe you feel stuck, or maybe things are going really great. Whatever that looks like for you, it's gonna be okay. But sometimes it's nice to do a mid-year check-in, kind of take a step back and just kind of look out and see where are you at, how are things going? You know, because a year is a long time and a lot can happen in a year. And that's why it's so great if you can do a mid-year check-in and kind of look at it and evaluate. Maybe some things ran its course and it's time to change some steps on the way to that goal. Doesn't mean the goal has to change. It just means that maybe some things in the process might have to be reevaluated. Or maybe you're further down the road than you thought. And you're like, wow, I've got to come up with some more steps. Great. Whatever that looks like for you, let's just take some time and do a mid-year check-in and see how are you doing. I want to share a quote with you, and it says this: a dream written down with a date becomes a goal, and a goal broken down into steps becomes a plan, and a plan backed by action makes your dreams come true. And so I want to share some simple steps that you can start applying to help you keep moving forward as you're kind of doing a 30,000 foot view, but just see where you're at, reevaluate, and keep moving forward and not give up on yourself and not give up on those goals. So one of the things that you can do is to start with the end in mind. You know, if you have that long-term goal of a year, and in a year you want to be at a certain place or accomplish certain things, now you want to back into it to the current date. See, this reminds me when I used to work on a corporate annual report, and you have a lot of data in there, a lot of financials that are in that report, and we would have a plan. We'd start with the end date of this is the production date of that annual report, and we would back it into today's date and have all the steps in place, the accountability that we all had to have to make sure that we were on track to get to that end result. The other thing to remember while you're kind of taking that step back and that 30,000 foot view and the mid-year check-in is to also remember the why. Why did you have this goal in place? Why did you want to accomplish this now and in this time frame? See, remembering your why is like that compass, and I've shared this before. It keeps you on track as to what you want to do and where you want to go. So as you're reevaluating or adjusting and you're achieving, remember why you wanted the goal in the first place. And then the other thing to remember is, what is that word that you had picked up for the year? See, a lot of times I go back to my word, which this year it's called intentional. And I always remind myself of that. In fact, I don't wait till the mid-year point. I look at that word quite frequently because I want to keep remembering why I'm doing what I'm doing, and I want to do it with the intention. The last two things I want to share with you are create accountability and then to look at what's working and what's not working. See, when you create accountability around you, whether that's a couple of people or five people, studies show that there's a 65% chance that you will accomplish your goals. So don't forget to create accountability around you to get to where you want to go. And then again, think about what's working and what's not working. You know, sometimes we have things in place and plans in place and they get us to where we are today, and that's great. But that's run its course. So now we have to bring in new processes to keep us going down the path. I want to close with this quote from Eleanor Roosevelt that I just think is so beautiful, and I want to use this to encourage you. And it says this: the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. My friend, I pray that you believe in the beauty of your dreams, and I pray that you believe that you will and you can accomplish those dreams. So as you do this check-in, whether it's mid-year or more frequently, just take that time to take a step back and just see what's working and what's not. Am I moving forward? Do I need to make some adjustments? Because that doesn't mean it's a no or a negative or you made a mistake. It just means you have to make some changes along the way. That happens to all of us. So until next time, my friends, continue to live that courageous life, be strong and be kind, and I'll see you in the next video.